thank you so much for joining me for a spider crawl video. So if you're a violin teacher, you know what that means. And let's just dive right into that. So I'm going to use a student-sized bow just because it's a little bit more efficient to go through these. So the basic one is just climbing up and climbing down. Because students want to put it on their lap, put it on the floor, I always say put a cloud underneath it. Now, if your student is really young, this will be difficult and they do need to start with it on the floor or a hand. But for the rest of you, let's go ahead and put a cloud underneath and we go up to the top. I like to say that we climb up to a mountain and we take a picture at the top and then we come back down, and here is where the students will say, it's difficult. And you will say, yes, yes it is. So if we like to tell stories, and I do, I'm very passionate about saying the spirit is fed, the body will work, so put a story in wherever you can. We'll say that we forgot our backpack at the top of the mountain and we've got to go back and get it. Maybe we eat a popsicle or do something fun at the top and we just come back down. So you can have a lot of playful fun with that. So that's what I would call level one. Level two, we're gonna put it horizontal and we're gonna climb horizontally. Now, stories again are really one of the best ways to optimize your success. And I like to say that you're a cat hunting a bug and you don't want to fling off the bug there. If you want to make it a tiger or something even more ambitious than a house cat, you can. But it's hard. It's going to be super hard to do that. That's not something a beginner could do. That's really, really tricky business right there. So right now I'm using my bow hand, and these should be something that beginners, intermediate students do all of the time to develop the dexterity needed for more expressive playing. So then we can also put it into our violin side. And again, same thing, just climb up and down, you get the picture, and you can go again horizontal, and it will feel very alien. I can say after decades of teaching, it's just a bizarre feeling, and that kind of lets you know what the students are feeling. So if you're a teacher watching this and have never done it in your violin hand, please do, just to get a little bit of a sense for what your beginner level students actually encounter in the process of learning. So after that's done, details that you could start to ask for are, did the thumb stay bent? Probably not. It probably did not. Were the fingers also malleable? So some students will do this, I can't even do it, I'm sorry, but it's some weird thing with straight fingers and they sort of go, I literally don't know how they do it, but it doesn't lead towards a bow hold. So you can start to ask for those details as they do this more. So again, once is never enough, repetition is the key to success. Now, I'm gonna end this with the ultimate challenge. Are you ready? Are you sitting down? One bow, see, that's what it's like. One bow in every hand. Oh my goodness. Ladies and gentlemen, is that just not outrageous and fun? I will tell you honestly, it's the first time I've ever done this. Live right here on YouTube. So be fun, be creative, challenge it. It does help both hands, although obviously is more directly applicable with your bow hand, but enjoy some spider crawls, have some great games, have some tricks, let us know, write a comment, we want to hear from you. We love your ideas. Thank you so much and hope to see you on another video.